on. Yes, that's her in the background. I will be doing a video for a New Year's Day vlog. All right, so you can see how my day went today. A puffy eyes, I think I was rubbing it this morning. But yeah.
Clean skin.
I have such a nice nighttime face routine. I'm gonna share it with you one of these days. But yeah. I'm gonna spread my bed now, and then mommy's gonna take baby O for a walk on the outside, and yeah, I'm gonna spread the bed, and then I'm gonna make a spinach omelette for her breakfast. I'm not sure what I'm going to eat yet, and maybe probably make the same thing for myself, and then we can start our day. We certainly have to get ready from now, because if we don't get ready from now, or if I don't start getting out her clothes from now, we will just be, you know, late. I don't have much to spread because I sleep on my top sheet last night. Usually I don't sleep on my top sheet because, I don't know, I think when you sleep on your top sheet, it gets messy. Because a lot of the sweat and this and that and whatever, it gets messy. So, yeah. This is her dolly Pinky, who she loves so much. It's dirty now, but you know, if you give it a wash for sure. But she loves Pinky. My mommy introduced her to Pinky. We have like a darker dolly, but she prefers this one, I guess, because it matches her complexion. The thing is, I really have to spread my bed every single time I wake up in the morning, unless I'm extremely late for something. But I spread my bed every morning because I feel like it gives the room just like a nicer, cleaner feel. And it makes me feel like I'm more organized throughout the day. Like, spread your bed and, you know, you have like a really good day. So, yeah. Where's the money? Yeah? Smoke? Oh. Bring her up on the balcony. We gotta set the tone for the new year, guys. Gotta set the tone. And one of the things about setting the tone for the new year is just that. So last year for me, I think I was a pretty uptight because of my anxiety and just like different things I was going through. So I felt like I needed to maintain a certain level of control. So that's why I was so uptight. So this year now, I'm trying to change that. So me kind of getting annoyed a while ago is just like, all right then, them light the fire. I can't control them, obviously. So I just have to work with it. So it's either I'm gonna let the baby go outside or let her stay inside, or just wait until the smoke clears and then she can, you know, she can go outside. So just like a lot of things I have to wrap up. These things are, may seem pretty simple, but they're actually very big things for people like myself and, you know, other people who are going through anxiety and just like control issues. So yeah, I'm gonna clean up my room now. All right, so I'm gonna put them play right, so because baby O sleeps like in the middle, so I don't want her roll off. She does this really cool thing where she actually sometimes, so if I put her to sleep on the bed and I'm outside, like out of the room or whatever, and if I don't have the camera on, I can tell when she's waking up. But she will wake up sometime and she'll come like right here. So not, she's such a smart baby. She doesn't like go off, she doesn't roll off of the bed, and she doesn't creep off of the bed or anything like that. She just like comes to the edge of the bed and like waits for me to come for her. It's you know, I think it's just a matter of learning to behave. Like, yeah? What? May I come? So as I said, I'm gonna now go and make some breakfast for baby O and myself. And you want me to make anything for you?
Whatever,
mom, spinach omelette for her. But probably just me. You want an egg sandwich? Exactly. So what you want? That's all? Mm-hmm. Egg. Plantain. Spinach. Almond milk. This. Cut sweet pepper. I have to get all my ingredients first before I start cooking, because when I want to start a cook, I'm gonna have this something then what I'm supposed to use, you know what I mean? As you can see, my kitchen is under construction. One of the things I do first before I start cooking is to boil out, is to boil my pots. So even though obviously them clean, but I have to make sure, say, you know, like sometimes you have a pot and you, for example, cook curry chicken, but you want to fry something in there. Even when you wash it out, you know, when you still fry the something in there, so you don't have the curry flavor, the curry look to it. So I boil my pot just to ensure that all of those things I get rid of. So small amount. I've never made this spinach thing for her. I bought it. I want to see if she would like it. Just a little bit. Probably can make it myself too. I'm gonna put some for myself. As well. Mommy don't eat egg. Salt. Actually. Mommy, I always find something to use with them, so yeah. Put something for putting in there. Okay, so. So today we're going to go in the road for New Year's. It's going to be a surprise. First of all, I can't really multitask. I can't talk and I can't or really find a subject to talk about while making this. So I guess it's one of those things I have to work on while I'm doing a vlog. Because most of the time I'm cooking, I'm actually... So the pot stop boil up there. I'm actually in my head a lot when I'm cooking, and that's a type of therapy. Kind of sweet. Did I show you guys my ingredients? All right, so let me show on the wagwan. I have the spinach right here, and the egg, and the sweet potato, tomato, and then you have the almond milk. I put the almond milk for the omelette for baby, so she can get maximum on the plate, and some salt. You know, you have the sheep and butter, you have this, and of course, you know, you have the spinach. So, and I forgot to show you, we have soybean oil. Usually, we use coconut oil, but it seems like we run out of it. So, I'm thinking about the dark oil. Plantain is actually an essential part of everything. It goes with everything, like planting and pear go with everything. I've turned on the stove because you know how planting stay, so if it's on your back, you know, say it's like a bottle. So you have to turn it down to make sure it's safe. You're good. Yeah, I had to just check my baby poo a while ago. You know what I'm just thinking about as well? How important it is to be consistent when you have a child, because her poo a while ago, when I was looking at it, was a little bit, there's nothing wrong with it, but it's, you know, like it's a little hard poo, not the softy one like me used to.
So usually it's been like a week or week and a half since we haven't given her any fruits in the morning. So I'm wondering if that's one of the reasons, but usually we give her fruits like melon, orange in the morning time, papaya sometimes. So we have to ensure that we continuously giving her the fruit so it kind of soften her stool, tell it what to plant, you know.
How it looks. Then I'm gonna beat it out. So this is breakfast. This is the papaya, the plantain, and the egg. And then you have the almond milk right here. So BRB, I'm gonna go and give her her breakfast.
So for my breakfast now, I have to take out the yolk. Because I'm going to take out the yolk, a beer bump, I'm going to come up on this nice clean face that I've been working on.
So broccoli, cauliflower, and the pumpkin.
So hopefully she will eat these things. I'm going to wash them off now and drop them in the pot. Time for my breakfast.
Plantain, egg, almond milk, and I'll take out the bread now. So my time now to get ready. So I always comb my hair first while baby O is sleeping. The most important thing for me to do is to bathe while she sleeps. Yet I am combing my hair. Risky. Because if you brush the drop, she would have certainly wake up. Simple thing. I don't really know how to do my hair since I've started to grow it back. So I'm just like default to the ketchup in a hair one. And I don't really like letting it out as much at this length at least. So this will have to do. So when I wash my face and things, then I can do my baby hair and all the works. So that's a new toothbrush too for the new year. So I just took a shower and now I'm getting my outfit ready so we can leave out ASAP because I don't want to stay late and I want baby girl to have some fun where we're going. A lot of heat about putting in my earring. Trying to do as many things as possible so I can just get ready to go. Baby here.
So this is the final product of how my face looks, and we're late, so I couldn't give you guys a proper chance to see what my outfit looks like, but we're on the way. All right, pulling up at the gas station. Look at that! Look! Oh, and can I see it? Oh, God. The view is lovely. You know my whole arm? Huh? My whole arm? Wow. Yeah. So guys, this is the end of the vlog. I just got home, so I'm gonna bathe off and team change over. Yes, and definitely get to bed. I'm hoping she sleeps through the night tonight. We'll see. All right, so thank you for watching. Remember to like, share, subscribe. And if you want more vlogs and stuff like this, let me know.
Yes, are you meant that, boots?